Welcome to one of the cornerstone cities for the MFL, Green Bay, Wisconsin, home of the Attackers.
Also home of the first semi-successful head transplant, Grim.
Yeah, whatever happened to that poor guy?
Well, he did all right for himself. He's the state mascot for head cheese.
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Purple Mutant Eaters go up against the Green Bay Attackers. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's a beautiful day for MFL football. At least in the booth with the AC, personal servants, and blood shield. Hi, Grim Blitzrow here with you, along with my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing that little hottie who works the deep fry at the concessions.
He said how, not who, you idiot. Even if you got the answer right.
And it's first and ten. Great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And that'll be second down and four. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and ten. Quick pass picks up maybe 2 yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go. And he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and ten. Well, he made the pass, but then a slap in the face by the defense.
Oh, that's me in the hotel bar every night.
Hey, your opening line needs work.
Why?
Really? What's a pretty girl like you doing here all by yourself? Are you a hooker?
Well, it's a fair question.
They pick up 3 on a short pass. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. The ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. 1st down and 7. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. And that'll be 2nd down and 4.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's...
No doubt about it. I'm taking you with me. He's at the 40. Oh, and they got him. That's a touchdown saving tackle. And it's 1st and 10. Oh. Second down in a very long. And they needed that big run right there, Bricks.
They sure fucking did, Grim. They sure fucking did.
And that'll bring up third down and 7. And then to first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. And he's running like a moose. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 5. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Second down and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And that'll bring up third down and 7. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
And it's first and 10. Second down and a lock. Dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Oh, and the defender cut off that pass like a suburban mom on the way to speak to the manager. And he sure got it. Oh, he just got crushed. First and 10.
I personally think the ginormous guy is compensating for something. Mark.
And these guys are not giving the quarterback many passing lanes to hit a receiver. Nice block by the defense there. Second down and 10. And he breaks away. He runs it for 3. And that'll bring up third down and 7. And he just wrestles away, and the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. To dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, mostly coffee. Tastes better like Eskimos burying salmon heads. Kimchi. I mean, anything really tastes good.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Third down and 3. Great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit, the quarterback goes down. Second down and more than the QB would like. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. First down and 3.
Get the hell out of here, man.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
And it's first and 10.
Welcome to McRoy Rage. How can I help you?
Yeah, I'll take a double Roy burger, large Roy fries, and a big Roy gulp.
Anything else?
Yeah, I'm just gonna rip your head off and get out of here. That's about it.
Oh, what a run there! Touchdown! No one was gonna stop him!
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sit
straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. And it's first and 10. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Second down and 10. He's not just burning down the house, he's taking it to the house. With a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. first and 10. And we're at the 2-minute warning. And it's first and 10. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes a look at it and keeps on.
First down. I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. And it's first and 10. Nicely done for a first down. Well, that's two timeouts burned, and you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
Yeah, I'm speaking from experience, Grim, but it really is hard to do both at the same time, and I have mastered it.
3-yard catch on the play.
Every little bit counts. Those 3 yarders might grow up to be somebody one day.
And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
4 yards on that one. And he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Third down and 3. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Monkey trying to fuck a greased football. He gets away in a hurry. And it's first and 10. The defender's one feet just kicked in. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Brits' ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex.
That pass was way off target, but I'm pretty sure the QB will blame the receiver as he always does. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
How many times?
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team.
And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. Second down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. To the races. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
It's first and 10. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
A pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
And that'll bring up third down and 7. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. Well, surprise me, he made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Oh, nice hit. And it's first and 10.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
5-yard gain on that pass play.
Hey, look at the coach. He's picking his nose. You know, they shouldn't put that on the Jumbotron. Seems like every time the camera shows him, he's either spitting, picking, grabbing himself in the privates. Hey, he should do it all at the same time.
The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the play. I know that's typical of all MFL players, but this is different. Trust me, very different. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down.
If you get one more bullshit penalty, you get one more for free.
You'll also probably lose the game. Just do the attack ref dirty trick.
second down and a lot. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down in a mile. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Third down and, well, good luck. That's a killer. It was right there and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
I don't understand. Why are they going for it, Grim? This seems like the situation where they should always...
Warp speed, engage. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
Yeah, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? Well, you're mistaken, man. You get up my grill, I'm going to ruin your world. I'm going to wreck it.
It's first and 10. And they pick up 9 with that catch.
Not enough for first, but still a nice game.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. Caught for the first down. First and 4. And they stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Hey.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Man, are these guys greedy or desperate? Either way, they're going for 2. And he gets into the end zone for the conversion.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's 1st and 10. Simple game when it comes down to it. And it's 1st and 10. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yep, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick and the QB is in a heap of trouble now. Second down in a very lot.
Oh, man, he really... That was a nice piece of running, Grim. That's a first down.
And it's 1st and 10.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's 1st and 10. That's a pass that went nowhere.
Oh, that's like me at the hotel bar every night.
Hey, maybe you need a better opening line than you want to see the teeth thrown out of the roof of my mouth.
What? The book How to Pick Up Girls and Tell Them Something Unique About Yourself. That's unique.
And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. Second down and nine. And he was stuck to him like glue. Third down and nine. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored.
Nice. Hey, you kill a ref. It's not murder if they have it covered, right? Take the hit. Do something about that ref, you pussies.
Third down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down and forever. And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. The punter for today is being played by my kid's sister. Or at least it seems. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and ten. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and six. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big peregrine. You're right.
You can tell he's a berserker because he's frothing at the mouth.
Oh, that guy. Oh.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. And first down. Running low on running backs. They have only two left. They need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and ten. And they run it for a couple of yards. And that'll be second and eight to go. Third down, and the punter is warming up. He's not going down.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten. And like every one of my barbecues, this guy's on fire. Does he like original or extra crispy? Now it looks like extra crispy. Oh, this guy just loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and ten. when you can go for two.
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, we're talking about points.
And he rubs it in for an easy 2 points. The momentum in this game may be shifting.
Ron, those are just my balls.
Hey, for sharing, Bricks.
Say what? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
Here comes the kicker.
Ma, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. There, maybe a yard. Second down and 9. Talking about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. Third down and 9. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and 10. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Third down and 9. It's the fourth quarter, and we're at the 2-minute warning.
2 minutes until what?
And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. Refuses to quit. They stay alive with 4 new downs.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
And it's first and 10. And he takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
When in a hurry up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
It's a time warp dirty trick. The last play is a race. How did they do that?
Did they go 88 miles per hour? Just asking.
Third.
Timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You gotta use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Hey, Bricks, they're going for two here. No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. He'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you recover an onside kick.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the kettle now. You know what?
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Grim, can I kill him?
Oh, great throw! Great catch! And then put 6 points on the board!
The defense can do anything to stop a throw that good, Grim!
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Wreck your world! You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world!
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick. The four people on the planet who care about rules and kickoffs must be happy to see a flag down. The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession.
Stealing ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. He's at the 20. Oh, and that kick to his highlight reel. That was perfect. And since he's a kicker, that brings him up to a one-hole highlight. And it's first and 10. That play didn't work. He'll have to rethink that. And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
Straight through the uprights. Put that one in the loss column. The Grim Bay Attackers lose the game.
And they lost me $50.
Good teams find a way to win, and bad teams find a way to lose. Looks like they've got some work to do after this one-point loss.
We've all got some work to do after this one. For example, your enunciation could have been a tad better, Grim, and Junior, you can't swear all the time.
I don't know what the fuck you're fucking talking about, you fucking shithead.
Speaking of shitheads, let's hear the MVP of today's game brag about the win. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN, want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.